हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी विल स्टडी लिमिट्स। दिस इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट टॉपिक ऑफ क्लास 11 एंड दिस टॉपिक लिमिट्स इज इसेंशियल फॉर कैलकुलस, मैथमेटिकल एनालिसिस एंड टू डिफाइन कॉन्टिन्यूटी एंड डिफरेंशिएबिलिटी। एंड first of all we will try to learn this topic with the help of our day to day life, that how can we define limit. See here, this is the figure. Suppose there are three points A, D and B. D stands for destination, and suppose you are on driving from A to D, and normally this takes time 1 hour. And if you start and the distance between A and D is 40 kilometer, on the other side also B to D distance is also 40 kilometer, and normally this is also will take 1 hour. Okay, now suppose you start driving from A to D, it means as you will be on this way, the time 1 hour, which is the time to reach from A to D, will decrease. And likewise, the distance also will increase. And then, because here we are starting, here the distance will be taken as zero, then this distance will increase and this time will decrease from 1 hour. And this way we can say that function of t, our distance is measured with the function of t. As t reaches to 1 hour, means as you are here, and you are just consuming all the time 1 hour, the distance will be 40 kilometer. Means this way you will reach up to your destination. And this is in the form of limit. We can say that limit function of t, as t is tends to 1 hour, is equal to 40 kilometer. Okay, and mathematically this is defined as limit is the value of the function approaches as the variable t approaches to some value. Okay, and now try to understand the existence of limit. This way we can define limit, but on the other hand, normally this takes from B to D again 1 hour and 40 kilometer. Okay, and if this is like this, that 1 hour and 40 kilometer, as from left hand side, then we can say the limit exists, because limit, left limit, this is named as, in terms of mathematical term, left limit, and this is named as right limit. And that is, left limit is equal to the right limit, then only we can say that limit exists. And then suppose this path is not so well as the path from A to D. Though the distance is same, this is 40 kilometer, this is also 40 kilometer. But once we'll start from B to D, and this path, this road is not so well, and then ultimately this time will increase from reaching B to D. That is, this will increase from 1 hour, and this will depend on the path. Maybe from 1 hour, it will increase by 1 hour or a half an hour, whatever. In that case, right limit and left limit is not equal. And then we can say that limit does not exist. For existence of limit, the left limit, that is this distance and this time, whatever the way we define, should be same. Okay. And now come on here, as x tends to a, that is the positive distance between x and a. This is numerically written as 0 less than mod of x minus a less than epsilon, and epsilon is a small positive integer. And then this way we can define concept of x approaches to a or x tends to a, because we are trying to reach from left and right both, and that is why ultimately the positive value, that is mod of x minus a, is decreasing, as decrease as can. So you can take epsilon smallest positive integer, and then we can say x approaches from left hand side or x approaches from right hand side, or in whole we can say that this is x tends to a. Now you try to understand with the help of this, and this is x axis and this is y axis, and say you are given this function, any function you can take function like this, and then the value of x is here and value of y is here. For again at x is equal to a, this value is coming L, as here you have seen. Okay, then for smallest difference between this and this, the smallest difference between this and this, okay, for a minus delta, this is L minus epsilon, where delta and epsilon both are smallest positive integer. I have written different letters for this because of being the value of x variable and y variable. Okay, and this way again, as this reaches from this to this, this reaches from this to this, and here with the help of this example, y is equal to fx is given x square minus 1 upon x minus 1, where x is not equal to 1, because if x will be 1, then this value cannot be determined. Then you can cancel this and you are getting x plus 1, that is 2. And with the help of this figure, you can see this is x axis and y axis, x plus 1. As this reaches from 1.1, 1.01 towards 1, this value reaches towards 2. Okay, because you can see here x is equal x plus 1, then 1 plus 1, that is 2. And though this is reaching from this to this, right to left, and here this is reaching from left to right, and in the same way here from downward to upward direction, because obviously this value will be less than 2 and here this value will be less than 1. And this way we can understand that how limit is defined and how limit is existing. Now this topic, that is existence of limit, will be more and more clear with the help of questions. Now we are going to discuss the question related to the existence of limit. This question is related to existence of limit. Show that limit of x tends to 2 mod of x minus 2 upon x minus 2 does not exist. Now how can we show? First of all, we will find left hand limit, that is for smallest positive integer. Here smallest positive integer we are taking h. Okay, so limit of x tends to, this is way of writing 2 to the power minus, that is left limit of 2 for the function fx. Fx is given x minus 2 upon x minus 2 in the terms of mod, and then the value mod means the value will be positive. So in place of x, we will write 2 minus h minus 2 mod of this upon 2 minus h minus 2. This is cancelled, and mod of minus h will take positive value, that is h upon minus h, h cancel, this is being minus 1. This is left hand limit, and in right hand limit we will find x tends to 2 to the power plus, this is way of writing 2 to the power plus or 2 to the power minus. Then limit of h tends to 0, 2 plus h, because whether this tends to right towards left. That is 2 plus h minus 2 upon 2 plus h minus 2, and this is cancelled, this is being h upon h, that is 1. You can see left hand limit is not equal to right hand limit, and so this limit does not exist. Now for the second question again, limit of x tends to 0 fx, where fx is defined in three ways. The value of fx is x when x less than 0, the value of fx is 0 when x is equal to 0, the value of fx is x square when x is greater than 0. We have to test whether this limit exists or not. Again, we will find left limit of 0, that is limit of x tends to 0 minus for the function fx. But 0 minus means x less than 0, the value of the function is x. And then we will take x, and that is 0 minus h, and substituting h is equal to 0, we are getting 0. And in right hand limit, that is x greater than 0, we are getting x square, that is 0 plus h whole square, and then substituting 0, we are again getting 0. This way, left hand limit is equal to right hand limit, and so for this function, the limit exists. Now, next question. For what value of p does the limit of x tends to 1 fx exist? Where f is defined by the rule, for x less than 1, 2px plus 3, for x greater than 1, 1 minus px square. And here we are given that this limit exists, and we have to find out value of the p. And this means left limit will be equal to the limit of the function at the given value x tends to 1. In the same way, right limit will also be equated to the limit of the function at x tends to 1. And this way we can equate and we can get this value. See here, limit of x tends to 1 to the power minus means left limit of this 2px plus 3, because this is x tends to 1, the function is 2px plus 3. And then putting the value limit of x tends to 1, 2px plus 3, x is equal to 1, this is 2p plus 3. And for right limit, that is x tends to 1 to the power plus, that is x greater than 1. So for this, the value of the function is 1 minus px square. Substituting here again, this is being 1 minus p. Equated both, because this is given that for what value of p this limit exists. And that is why equating this, we are getting the value of p is equal to minus 2 by 3. Now we will discuss the questions on the theorems related to the basic operations of limit. That is, the limit of sum of two function is equal to the sum of their limits. In the same way, limit of difference of two functions is equal to the limit of their difference. In the same way, another for product also, limit of product of two function will be equal to the product of their limits, and limit of quotient or division of two functions will be equal to the limit of their quotient. Okay, and another also, powers will also be related with the limits, and all these theorems will be applied with the help of the questions. Now we will discuss with the help of questions all these theorems. Now questions. This is first type of question, that is the direct substitution of method of finding limits. Suppose you are given any question, limit of x tends to 2, x square plus 5x plus 6 upon 2x square minus 3x. After substituting x is equal to 2 in the given expression, if the values are coming finite, then we understand that this is the type of direct substitution. And in this, not any extra calculation, you just substitute x is equal to 2, and this way you are getting, this is 10. In the same way, another question, limit of x tends to 0, ax plus b upon cx plus d. You substitute x is equal to 0, you are getting b upon d, which is also finite. This is first type of method of finding limits. Okay, and now second type of method. In this type, first of all, we substitute the value x is equal to 3 in the given expression. And if this is coming in the form 0 upon 0, infinity upon infinity, 0 into infinity, or 1 to the power infinity, or any other form, this form is called as indeterminate form. And for this, you can go through on my link, which is for indeterminate form of limits of class 12. And there you will find in detail that what is the meaning of indeterminate form of limits and how we are using L'Hospital's rule for finding the limits of this type of expression. Now here in class 11, after finding 0 upon 0, then since this is not finite, firstly we will check when this coming finite, then we will substitute directly as we have done in the last. And now here, if this is not finite, this is indeterminate form, then you factorize this, and I factorize here using class 10 method, that is the way we were factorizing remainder theorem, that is substituting x is equal to 3, hit and trial method, and this is coming 0, so x minus 3 is a factor, and this way we can, after division, or directly you can write this way, x minus 3, x minus 3, x minus 3, and then equate this, so as this is x cube minus 3x square, then minus 5x into x means minus 5x square means minus 8x square, then plus 45. Okay, and after factorization, the numerator is being this, and the denominator after factorization is splitting middle term being x minus 3 into 2x plus 3. Writing this form, this is cancelled, and then after substituting x is equal to 3, we are getting the finite value, and so this is the value of limit. Now, another type, if the given function involves square root, then first of all we will realize whether numerator or denominator where the square root is given. And before this, you can test here x is equal to 0, this is 1 minus 1 upon this is 2 into 0, and that is 0 upon 0 form, and which is indeterminate form of limits. And then we will apply rationalizing the numerator by multiplying root 1 plus x plus root 1 minus x in numerator and denominator, and then after simplifying, this is being this value, then substituting x is equal to 0, this is coming finite. Wherever the value is coming finite, then this value will be the value of the given limit. Okay. In the same way, second type also, here you can see this is also in square root, then we will, you can check here, putting x is equal to 0, this is 1 minus 1 upon this 0, that is again 0 upon 0 form, which is indeterminate form of limits, and then again we will rationalize the numerator after multiplication with the root 1 plus x cube plus root 1 minus x cube in numerator and denominator. And then after simplifying, this is being x, and that is putting x is equal to 0, the value is coming 0. Okay, now next type, in this fifth method, we will use the expansion of the given expression. As limit of x tends to a, x to the power n minus a to the power n upon x minus a, finding this, and this will come n a to the power n minus 1. Now, how can we find this limit? First of all, test this, putting x is equal to a, this is again coming 0 upon 0 form. And then we will write expansion of this. First of all, we let x is equal to a plus h, where h is the small positive integer, and then change of limit x tends to a, then as x tends to a, h will be 0, h tends to 0, and then writing the value of x in terms of this, this is a plus h minus a to the power n upon a plus h minus a, that is h, then expansion of a plus h to the power n, binomial expansion, we will use binomial expansion, and you already know binomial expansion, that is a to the power n plus nc1, a to the power n minus 1 h plus nc2, a to the power n minus 2 h square, and this way this will decrease and this will increase, ultimately this will be h to the power n minus a to the power n, and this a to the power n will be cancelled with this a to the power n, and ultimately this is coming 1 upon h nc1 a to the power n minus 1 h, then dividing by h, and this h will be cancelled, and we will get nc1 a to the power n minus 1, and rest of the h containing terms will not be taken because we have already taken h small positive integer, then square of small positive integer will goes on smaller and smaller, and that is why these terms can be excluded from here, and then ultimately we are getting nc1 a to the power n minus 1, that is n a to the power n minus 1. This is the value of this, and this is frequently used directly in doing questions also. Without expanding the given expression, you can use this directly also. Now, related questions. This question is of the type limit of x tends to 0, x to the power n minus a to the power n upon x minus a, x to the x tends to a, is equal to n a to the power n minus 1. Okay. Now, limit of x tends to 3, x to the power 5 minus 243 upon x square minus 9. First of all, we will write in terms of square. Then we can see that this is the x minus 3 can be divided and multiplied in numerator and denominator. And this way we are getting limit of x tends to 3, x to the power 5 minus 3 to the power 5 upon x minus 3. And this limit can be written in quotient, that is x square minus 3 square will come here minus x minus 3. And then this value comparing with the given value x to the power n minus a to the power n upon x minus n, n a to the power n minus 1. Here n is equal to 5, a is equal to 3, then 5 into 3 into 5 minus 1, because here denominator 1, in the same way here, okay, 2 and then 3 to the power 2 minus 1, then after simplifying we are getting 135 upon 2. Now next type, this is of the type infinite limit of the function. Whenever we are getting this type limit x tends to infinity 4x minus 3 upon 2x plus 7, we will try to change in terms of 1 upon x, because as x tends to infinity, then 1 upon x tends to 0. Okay, because 1 upon infinity is equal to 0, and that is why we will change the given expression in terms of 1 upon x. Here simply dividing by x in numerator and denominator, we are getting 4 minus 3 upon x upon 2 plus 7 upon x, and this term will be 0, substituting x is equal to infinity, this is also 0, then 4 upon 2, and the answer is 2. Now next, limit of x tends to infinity, x cube plus 6x square plus 1 upon x to the power 4 plus 3. How can we change this? We divide numerator and denominator by x cube, and this is being 1 plus 6 upon x plus 1 upon x cube whole upon x plus 3 upon x cube. Then substituting x is equal to infinity, this is, and this is, okay, and then we are getting this terms is 0 and this is also extends to infinity. So this will be 0 because 1 upon infinity will be 0. And here again, next question, root x within bracket root x plus c minus root x. This is the type of rationalizing. I told you that whenever we are getting the expression in terms of square root, first of all we should change rationalizing the numerator and denominator, whatever given. Here in numerator, this is root x plus c minus root x, then multiplying numerator and denominator by root x plus c minus plus root x, and then this is rationalized and this is being root x, c root x, and upon this, then this is cancelled and we are getting, after taking root x common here, this is 1 plus c upon x plus 1, and this is substituting x tends to infinity, this will be 0, and the value left is c upon 2, and this is the answer. Now next type, in finding the limits of trigonometrical limits, that is, we will use the formula which is applicable in the given expression. As here, sine 2x plus sine x upon sine 5x minus sine 3x. In this, you already studied all the formula in compound and multiple angles. That is, sine c plus sine d will be used here. Sine c minus sine d will be used. Okay. And then, one more thing. In trigonometrical limit, these two can be used directly, and the proof is not in your course. Limit of x tends to 0, sine x upon x is equal to 1, and limit of x tends to 0, tan x upon x is equal to 1. And here, sine c plus sine d upon sine c minus sine d, 2 sine c plus d upon 2, cos c minus d upon 2. And again, 2 cos c plus d upon 2, sine c minus d upon 2. After using this, this 2 cancel and this is being tan 4x, then cos 2x means 1 minus 2 sine square x, because sine x in the denominator, we will apply 1 minus 2 sine square x formula of cos 2x, then opening this tan 4x upon sine x minus 2 into limit of x tends to 0 tan 4x into sin x, because this is cancelled. Now here we studied that limit of x tends to 0 tan x upon x is equal to 1. If in place of this we write here 4x and 4x and 4x, that also will be 1. And here in if x tends to 0, then 4x will also be tends to 0. And that is why here writing in that form and then multiplying and dividing by 4x in numerator and denominator, we are getting this value, and which is equated to 1. And here this can be written in the form of denominator, 4 into limit of x tends to 0 sine x upon x, because we can use quotient also in limits. And then here also applying same way, this is being 1 and this will be 0, and this then these three terms multiplied will be 0, and ultimately we are getting this 4, because this is 1, this is 1, and this is 0, and ultimately the answer is 4. Now next type, this is evaluation of trigonometrical limits when x tends to a. Here in this question, x tends to pi by 2, in place of a this is pi by 2, 1 minus sin x upon pi by 2 minus x whole square. In this type of question, we will let here x is equal to pi by 2 plus h as x tends to pi by 2. Substitute here pi by 2, this is 0, and then x tends to 0. And so this way we can change this limit, h tends to 0, 1 minus sine pi by 2 plus h upon this is minus h and whole square, and rest of the steps same, as we will use the formula of trigonometry, compound and multiple angles. Here 1 minus cos h means 2 sine square h by 2 upon h square, then changing in the form of sin x upon x, limit of x tends to 0. Here x tends to 0, h by 2, and that is why we will write in terms of h by 2 by dividing and multiplying by 4, and then this is being 1 upon 4, this value will be 1, 2 into 1 upon 4, and this is coming 1 by 2. Now, last type of the limits, this is exponential type of limit. Actually, in exponential and logarithmic type of limits, we must learn the expansion of e to the power x or log 1 plus x, okay? And then write accordingly here, limit of x tends to 0, x within bracket e to the power x minus 1 upon 1 minus cos 2x. Here expansion of e to the power x, 1 plus x upon factorial 1 plus x square upon factorial 2, in the same way increasing, and then minus 1. And this one will be cancelled. 1 minus cos 2x, we know 2 sin square x, and then taking x common, this is being x square, and rest of the terms is this, and then 1 by 2 here common, then limit of this x tends to 0, and this value x square common, then 1 plus x upon factorial 2 plus x square upon factorial 3 plus this, putting x tends to 0, these terms will be 0, and this x square will be in the denominator, sin square x upon x square, and then we can use quotient form of this, that is, this can be rewritten as 1 upon limit x tends to 0 sin square x upon x square, and this value is 1, and so the value of this limit is 1 by 2. And now logarithmic type of limits, limit of x tends to e, log x minus 1 upon x minus e. Whenever we will change the limit, limit of h tends to 0, log e plus h minus 1 upon e plus h minus 1. And then this is coming, log e plus h minus log, this can be 1 written as log base e, and that is why after dividing e, this is being 1 plus h upon e, whole upon h upon e. E can be divide and multiply, and now this is of the form, limit of x tends to 0, log 1 plus x upon x is equal to 1, and then this value is equal to 1, and so the answer is 1 upon e. Actually, we are getting this by the expansion of log. And now here I have written some expansion which is used here in this chapter. A to the power x is equal to 1 plus x log base e a plus x square upon factorial 2 log base e a square. You will have to learn this. In the same way, second expansion, e to the power x, 1 plus x square upon factorial 2 plus x square upon factorial 3. Expansion of log 1 plus x, x minus x square upon 2 plus x cube upon 3 minus x square x to the power 4 upon 4 and up to infinite. In the same way, expansion of sin x, x minus x cube upon factorial 3 plus x to the power 5 upon factorial 5, and in the same way up to infinite. And then for cos x, 1 minus x square upon factorial 2 plus x to the power 4 upon factorial 4 minus x to the power 6 upon factorial 6. And this way you should learn these expansions. Now next question. These two questions are very tricky question. Limit of x tends to 0, 10 to the power x minus 2 to the power x minus 5 to the power x plus 1 upon x tan x. Okay. First of all, we will factorize this. This can be written as 2 to the power x and 5 to the power x. Then 2 to the power x minus 5 to the power x plus 1. Then taking 2 to the power x common, this is being 5 to the power x minus 1. And this way, 5 to the power x minus 1 and 2 to the power x minus 1 in denominator x tan x. Okay, then multiplying and dividing by x, and then this is changing in the form of limit of x tends to 0, 5 to the power x minus 1 upon x. and this is of the type limit of x tends to 0 a to the power x minus 1 upon x is equal to log base e a. And you know how this we find. I just given you the expansion of a to the power x. You just write the expansion and then this will be cancelled and ultimately you will get log base e a, and the terms containing the smallest positive integer with highest power will be cancelled. Now here this way this is log 5 and this value is log 2 and this is we know 1. Okay, and this way log 5 and log 2 is the answer. And this way you have seen that in the single question we have used so many methods that we studied. Okay, now next type log base limit of x tends to 5 3 to the power x minus 3 to the power 5 upon x minus 5, changing the limit x is equal to 5 plus h as x tends to 5 h tends to 0. And then writing here x is equal to 5 plus h minus this upon 5 plus h minus 5, then changing this 3 to the power 5 and 3 to the power h minus this, and then this value is coming log base e 3 and 3 to the power 5 common which is coming out. So the answer is 3 to the power 5 log base e 3. And this way we studied all types of questions of limits up to class 11. Now for studying L-Hospital rules and more types of limits question, you watch my video that is indeterminate form of limits of class 12. And now please subscribe my channel for getting more and more upcoming videos. Thank you.